In this Java programming video tutorial, we will discuss introduction to Java file management concepts. We will see how to create data files using Java program. We will discuss how to perform read, write, and append operations on a text file. We will also discuss how to delete a file using Java program. References and acknowledgements to developers of Java programming and NetBeans IDE. Now, real-life software projects maintains large amount of data. For example, records related to students, exams, employees, products, places, temperature, etc. And a file is a location on disk where data is stored. So if we talk about student management system or a school management system, we store student-related data into a student file. So this student file is stored under our hard disk. Now, Java programming provides many classes and methods to manage such data files. So, in this video tutorial, we will discuss most commonly used file management operations under Java project. Now, there are five basic operations that usually we perform under file management related concepts. The first one is we are creating a file from our Java program. Then we perform read, write, and append operations on a file. And we may also delete a file from our program. So these are five basic operations that we are performing under file management concepts. The file class from Java IO package allows us to work with files. Other package like java.nio can also be used to work with files. Now to use this file class, we write import java.io.file. So this statement will allow us to use file class in our program. And then we create one object called myfile in this example. And after creating this myfile object, we will be able to perform various operations on data1.txt file. Now there are many popular methods under file class available to manage files. So these are some of the methods listed here which can be used to perform various operations which are shown here. For example, to create a new file, we can use create new file method. To delete a file, we may use delete method. So these are the methods which can be used to perform operations on a file. In this tutorial, we will be using these four methods. Now to create a file, we will be using create new file method. To read data from a file, we will be using read method. To write data to a file, we will be using write method. And to delete a file, we will be using delete method. Now these methods, create new file method is available under io.file. The read method will be using from file reader class. The write method will be using from file writer class. And delete method will be using from file class. This file, file writer, and file reader, all these classes are available under java.io package. So let's use NetBeans IDE to perform Java file operations. For demonstration purpose, I'll be creating a new Java project, file management project, under E Drive Java demo folder. So in my computer, under E Drive Java demo, I'll be creating a project called file management project. So this is file management project into which now we'll be creating a package called p1, and we'll be storing all our classes into this p1 package. Into this p1 package, let's create a new class. And this class is for creating a data file demo. So let's create file demo class. Create file demo class is now ready. Let's write our main function. And in this program, our objective is to create a data file. This is our main function, and we'll be creating object of file class. So my file is the object, and data1.txt is the file which we want to create in the disk of this computer. Now you can see some error is indicated by this ID. So this is regarding importing file class. So just click here and import java.io.fileclass. So you can see now file class is imported into this program. So now let's call create new file method. So this method can be applied on my file object. So just write your object name myfile.createNewFile, and this method will help us in creating a new file in the local system. Now this method is a boolean method and this will return true and false. So just to print appropriate message, what we are going to do is we'll be using if statement, and then we write appropriate message here. File created successfully. In case of some error, we will print error. File creation error. Now here also we can see a kind of small indication, and this is regarding exception handling. So here what you have to do is just click this and surround this statement with try catch clause. So what will happen, two new statements will be added here, try and catch. So in case of any error during execution of this block, the control will be transferred to this catch clause, and the statement which is written here inside this catch clause will be executed. So we can replace this statement with simple one also, like we can print just appropriate message file error. So basically this try catch clause we are writing to handle any runtime error. So our main objective here is to create a file. So if everything is okay, this statement, this method will create data1.txt file into the folder where this project is saved. So in my computer, this is the folder file management project. Under this folder, data1.txt file will be created. So let's run this program now. File created successfully. You can see this data1.txt file is created, and this is the blank file. Now we'll be writing a program to add data into this file, and then we'll be reading data from the same file. You can also remove the import statement which are not used in this program. So we can remove this also because that is not used. But these two classes are required in executing this program. Suppose we want to create a file at a specified location. In that case, what you can do is, instead of writing this default statement and path, what you can do is you can specify the custom path like this. If you want to create this data1.txt file under E drive Java demo folder, so we can write it like this also. In that case, this statement is not required, and this will create a file under the folder which we are specifying. Now let's write a Java program to write content into a file. For that, I'll be creating a new class under the same project, same package. File write demo. So here you can see our file write demo class is ready. Now objective of this program is to write data into a file. So let's write our main function. And first of all, we'll be creating one string object. the data which we want to store in our system, in our file. So let's say 101 is roll number, then name, and then address of student. After this, we'll be creating object of file writer class. So this is file writer class, and the object name is output. Now, as a parameter, we'll be writing a file name into which we want to write this data. Remember that you can read this data using scanner object also, but here we are just using this data variable, and this will be writing in data1.txt file. Now once again, this is asking for importing a class, so just import a file writer class. So file writer class is now imported. To remove this error, just add try catch clause. Again, you can simplify this error message also. This is file write error message. Now let's write our actual logic here. We will be using output object, and we call write method. Now along with write method, we will pass a variable called data. So this data variable contains this information that we want to write into this file, data1.txt file. And after writing this data, let's just write appropriate message. Data is written successfully. One more step which we have to write here, and we have to close this object. Output.close. Now, before we run this code, let's go to that file first. So this is the file where we want to write our data. So currently you can see there is no data in this file. It's a 0 KB. Now let's run this program. And when we run this program, this data will be written into that file. So just run your code, and we will get this message: data is written successfully if everything is okay. Now let's go to that file. You can see this is 1 KB now. When we run this, see, this is the data which is written into this file recently. This is how writing data into a file is very simple. You can remove any unused classes from your program. Now let's write a Java program to read data from a file. For that, let's create a new class under the same package, same project, file read demo. File read demo class is ready, and our objective is to read data from a file. Let's write our main function. Now, once we read data from a file, that we will store under one variable. So for that, let's create a data variable. And this variable can store up to 100 characters. So that is why we are declaring char100. Now, to read data from a file, we will be using file reader class. So of a file reader class, create one object called input. And the specify file name from which we want to read data. So data1.txt file, we will be reading data from this file, data1.txt, which is recently created. Now once again, you can see this error. We have to import this class. So import java.io.filereader class, and then one more surround statement by try catch clause. Simplify our error message. and this time file read error. You can remove this additional import statements. And after creating this input object, we have to just call input.read method. So this read method will take one parameter as input, and that is data. Now observe that when we have added exception for this line, file not found exception is added here. But as we are also executing read method, we have to also take care about IO exception. So what we can do is, instead of this file not found exception, we can directly write IO exception, and this will take care about both these statements. And as we are writing IO exception, we have to import that respective class IO exception. So in that case, we can remove this file not found exception import statement. So after executing this read method, let's print appropriate message: data received from a file. And the data which is received from a file is saved under this data variable. So let's print that value also, which is received from a file. And after completing this, after printing this data, just close your input object. So all done. Now let's run this code, and this will read data from data1.txt file. So this is the data which is actually taken from this file, data1.txt file. This is the data which is stored here, and that we are reading using this program, Java program. So this is how reading data from a file is also very simple. Just create file reader object and execute read method. Remember that in this program, this data variable can store only 100 characters, because that is the limitation of this data variable. This is the size of data variable. If we want to read data line by line, then we have to write a separate logic for that, and that we will discuss in our upcoming file management tutorial. Now let's write a Java program to append data into the existing file. For that, I have created file appenddemo.java program in the same package, same project. Let's write our main function. Let's create one string variable. This data is appended. So basically, we'll be writing this data into the existing file. Now let's use FileWriter class. Let's create output object. And the file into which we want to append our data. So data1.txt file in which we want to append data. And one more parameter, true. So this true parameter will indicate that we want to append our data into the existing file, data1.txt file. Once again, import FileWriter class and add try catch clause. Simplify your statement. Out. File append error. Remove this additional imports. After this, just execute output.write method and pass the data variable. Then print appropriate message. And after this, last line is output.close. So when we run this, this program will append this string at the end of content of this file. let's run this code now. Data appended successfully. So let's check that file. And this is the data1 file. And you can see this is the content which is appended to this existing content of the file. So this is how appending content in file is also very simple. Now let's write a Java program to delete a file. And for that, I have created a delete file demo Java program into the same package and same project. Let's create a copy of this file first. And let's rename this with data2. So we will be deleting this data2.txt file from our program. So let's write our main method. And into this main method, let's use file object. So my file, and this time we will specify data2.txt because this is the file which we want to delete from our system. Now, to delete a file, the method is delete. Delete is the method name, and this is a Boolean method, so this will return true and false. So if file is successfully deleted, in that case this will return a true. So let's write if statement, and we will write appropriate message here: file deleted successfully. And in case of false, once again write appropriate message: failed to delete a file. Now suppose we want to print file name also, what we can do is we can add here a file name also by writing it like this: my file dot get name. So this will fetch the name of that file, and that will be printed along with this message: file deleted successfully. Let's write it like this: name plus successfully. So this will print appropriate message: file deleted followed by file name and then message successfully. Once again here, error, we have to import this file class. So let's add io.file class. So that class is imported now. And let's run this file. So file deleted data2.txt successfully. Let's check that folder. So this data2.txt file is now deleted from this folder. If we change this file name data1.txt and then if we run this, what will happen? Be careful, this will delete data1.txt file from this folder. So you can see now data1.txt file is also deleted. So whenever you execute this program, file delete program, be careful because your file will be deleted from your system. In this video, we had seen how to create a data file. Then we have also discussed read, write and append operations. And finally, we had seen that how to delete a file. In our upcoming video, we will discuss how to perform search, replace and other important file processing related aspects. Till then, enjoy. Take care.